These dates are gonna be the death of me.
What's going on, y'all? Hey, what's going on, man? I'm so excited to come back to you guys with another motherfreaking vlog. Man, we are almost officially, well, not even almost, we are 1 month into our raw vegan fast. A little dance. But yeah, I'm super, Zoe's over there killing a little snack, as you can see. I hear you in my video, girl. Anywho, your girl has officially hit 1 month of raw vegan. I'm so excited. I'm so proud of myself. Time kind of has been going by fast, but also a little bit slow because your girl's still not even halfway through. One more week and then we hit the halfway mark. So yeah, but it's been good so far. Today I kind of wanted to come to you guys with a 3-4 week update and also kind of like take you guys with me as we reset on this beautiful Sunday. I have nothing left in my refrigerator, so we have to go grocery shopping. We gotta make juicertins, and I feel like this is the perfect time to unpack week 5 and 6's protocol. So yeah, super excited about that. I'm gonna be taking you guys along with me so you get a little sneaky peek on what we get in for the week. I feel like this week I'm gonna kind of keep it pretty simple. I've been doing a lot of fun flavors, a lot of fun juices, but I think I'm just gonna keep it easy. Keep it easy this week. We shall see. We'll see how the stores are speaking to me. But anyways, either way, I'm so excited to talk to you guys. And I'm excited to bring you guys along with me, so I hope you're ready for the day. A day with me. A day in the life. A Sunday reset. You know the deal. I'll see y'all at the store.
All right, first stop, seeded watermelons. We got our seeded watermelons. Bro, they be over here trying to take all my watermelon. I think this is a good one. It's like decent. We'll go with that. Watermelons. Some organic celery here. Yeah, I think that's good. Three stalks of celery. Alright, I think that we got everything we need from here. Seeded watermelons, celery.
Alright, next stop.
Right, can't go grocery shop without going to Trader Joe's. All right, your girl is at Trader's. It feels so bomb outside. Groceries from Trader's. Trader's is lit, okay? I used to be like, to Trader's, but Trader's is lit.
Okay, for the price, I got all these groceries for $100.
Steal.
Whole Foods could never. But Whole Foods got that too. Whole Foods, oops, I dropped my phone. Whole Foods definitely got that shit. We about to pack all this stuff up, and speaking of Whole Foods, that's gonna be our last stop. That's where I always go to get like the last stuff, so. Here we come.
What's up, y'all? Your girl is back from the store. I tried to get a little bit of clips, so y'all will see if it's entered in there. But now your girl got groceries. I'm laughing because I said I was gonna keep it simple this week, but I feel like I literally bought the whole grocery store. So You can see your girl got groceries and the little flowers from Trader's. You know how the vibe is. Gotta get flowers from Trader Joe's. So your girl is about to unpack and kind of like give you guys a little miniature grocery haul. So let's get it. All right, guys. Ow. Your girl has officially unboxed, well, unpacked all the groceries. And I'm just looking at this table like, girl, you said that you wasn't gonna even get that much this week. But I just felt so inspired. I told y'all I was gonna let the store talk to me. So here we are, our little groceries. Let's get into it. Look at that. Look at that. We got groceries. We got so much groceries. Your girl is stocked up. I bought tons of stuff to make green juice. I look, you should have bought more apples. So my green juice is probably gonna taste real green this week. Tons of cherries, cause I be killing those. We got some melons, cause this last week I made this fire, like melon, cantaloupe, orange, and mango juice. So definitely gonna run that back. Nectarines is like my favorite fruit at the moment to like just kill, like. I'm killing nectarines. They getting ate. And I'm actually gonna try something different today. Well, maybe not today, but like this week. I seen this recipe and I'm gonna do it. So it's zucchini noodles, tomatoes. You blend it with the basil, garlic, seasoning, and you got pasta. So we're gonna run that one real quick. But yeah, this is your girl groceries for the week. Now it's time to clean everything and get it prepped and ready. Make some juice and yeah, it's your girl.
What's up y'all? Your girl's back. And I know the vlog kinda got cut short. We really didn't see too much, but I didn't realize that I kinda really didn't record a good part of the middle of my fast. It became so like mundane, so like, same things that I were doing, I just continued to do those things. So I kind of just wanted to sit here and talk to you guys and tell you a little bit just how the middle of my fast went. So this is gonna be a recap of week 3, 4, as well as 5 and 6. Yeah, we'll do that. And then the next video is probably gonna be the last video, and I'm just gonna do a recap of 7 and 8, 9 and 10. Just cause there really wasn't really much afterwards. But yeah, so weeks 3 and 4, those went pretty smooth. I kind of started to build my routine. So things are pretty easy to kind of be consistent with. So every Sunday would be my reset day. That's the day where I would just go to the market and get everything. As you can see in the vlog, that day I would literally get everything. I would make all of my juices, well, at least most of them, and I'll save like maybe like a watermelon or so for like in the middle of the week if I just run out of juice, and kind of have that for the whole time. Other than that, I eat the fruit that you've seen. And week 4, 5, 6, I kind of started dabbling into making more savory dishes. So I'm gonna put like some pictures of kind of like some dishes I made. I made this raw vegan tomato pasta with the zucchini noodles. I made those nori wraps that I often talked about. What else did I make? I made a kelp noodles one time. Yeah, kelp noodle pasta, like a Thai style of a pasta. And yeah, aside from that, it's just gonna be fruit. I know that I may not have done this fast 100% perfect, like Uyaki would be like, yes girl, you the one. I don't think I did the fast in that way, but my main focus was to be raw vegan and stick with fruits and veggies mostly. I did dibble dabble in a little bit of nuts and seeds. So like I would make a hemp seed dressing. So I have like a hemp seed ranch, still just fruits and veg, but like I use hemp seeds. Or when I made like my Thai food, I did use a little bit of tahini. So like sesame seed paste to make like an Asian style dressing. So like I'm not sure if these things 100% follow the rules, but I was raw. Like, I didn't eat anything cooked, and I kept it pretty much fruits and veg. Like, if it got seed in there, if it got seeds, I'm eating it, you know? So, and I did it this way because this is what made it possible for me to do it. Like, if I had to be 100% however he said, yeah, I probably would have did it, but me going through this fast has been very enjoyable. Like, no complaints. I don't feel like any kind of way. I don't feel super restricted, aside from, of course, not eating hot food. But I got to have fun. I got to be creative, making different juice combos, making different meals. And I think that's the most important thing, is to stick with the raw, stick with the fruit and the veg, and just follow through. Like, I would rather do it a little bit imperfect than to not do the fast at all. You know what I'm saying? So weeks 3 and 4 went pretty smooth. Week 5 and 6 is kind of where I kind of finally started feeling a little bit of a different type of a way. So week 5, I kind of got, I wouldn't say sick, but kind of like I was very clogged up. Like, I had a lot of mucus buildup in me for like week 5 and 6. So I kind of wasn't feeling super duper hot. Like, I still had energy, but I was congested. Like, I felt like my body was kind of like purging. So I feel like I kind of hit the purge at the 5-ish week mark. And I think a big reason for that for me personally is because, so with my Geogenetic Cleanse package, I did put my own personal notes that was based off of my own health conditions. And so week 5 and 6 protocol was modified for me. So what the package usually comes with, the package usually comes with what would be included in week 7 and 8, which is focusing more on the brain, the nervous system, the adrenal system, like things like that. But for me, he did switch my 5 and 6 package to fit what you would get when, if you were to get the kidneys and adrenal package from him. So if you were to purchase his kidneys and adrenal package only, that is what my protocol was for week 5 and 6. Unfortunately, I don't have the pills or the package, because of course I'm coming to you guys now, and low-key I'm finished with the fast, but I wanted to just kind of let you know how this went. But what was included was my it was a kidney and adrenal tea that was included. I did get a blood purifier in there, and I did get an atomic strengthener. Those are the two that I remember the most. But it was some items that was very similar to what I've already had in this package. So if you were to get the Geogenetic Cleanse, you might not have this specific kit included in yours. But for me, I did receive the kidneys and adrenal package to take during week 5 and 6. I think that's kind of why I felt a little bit more of a purge, because this is probably something that my body really needed. It really needed to clean out my kidneys and my adrenals, which makes sense to me, thinking of all of my personal health conditions that I dealt with. So I felt like during that time, I kind of went through a purge. I was kind of just like congested. I had like snotty nose, kind of felt a little bit more tired during this time. So yeah, but eventually it went away. So by week 6, I felt better, and I was kind of like back to normal. So yeah, that's really about it, guys. Like, it ain't been really nothing too crazy. Thank you guys so much for just commenting and leaving your questions. I hope that I answered most of them. I was trying to think of what you guys were kind of asking me. I'm going to try and link the caps in these videos from the Amazon caps that I bought for the juices. And yeah, so sorry that I don't have the herbs for you guys for this last week set. But when we do the next video, I do have the herb capsules, and I'm so excited you guys kind of get to see just how I decided to end my fast. It was so therapeutic, super fun, and I just hope anyone that's doing this, like, you really take the time to also do just a spiritual and mental cleanse in the middle, at the end, whatever, because I feel like it is just much needed and super therapeutic, and you're going to enjoy it. I did. So thank you guys so much for watching my videos, and can't wait to get the next one out. So I'm probably gonna have the next one out super soon. Like I said, I'm done with the fast now, and just leave any questions at the end of this video so I can answer them in the next video for like whatever you want to know about, like how I felt throughout the whole fast, or the, you know, any questions, because now I'm done, so I can answer any questions and all that jazz. So thank you guys, see you next time. I said, ooh, I want that one. I want that one. Ooh, shit, I want. Shit, I want. You know what's this? Make a nigga say, yeah. Hello, yeah, yeah. Is it mine? Yeah, yeah.